Hi, my name is Jonathan Hicks. I'm back at the Dice Cup, and this evening I'm joined by
Amy,
Steve,
Dean,
and we just finished playing Crown of Amara, which is an interesting game. It's built on essentially two rondelles. So on your turn, you're going to be playing one card. You're going to hand the cards, and you pick one card, and you play it either in the one spot, the two spot, or the three spot. So let's say I put it in the two spot. This means I can move two spaces on either this rondelle or this one. You've always got to go clockwise, so let's say I go for this one. I would move one, two spaces, and then you get to take the appropriate resource. But one thing you can do is, early on in the game, I've actually managed to put an assistant here. When you land, if I'd gone one, two, and landed here, then you can pay resources here to add an assistant, which means in future rounds, when you land on this space, not only do you get the action, in this case this would get me wheat, but the assistant gets to take this action as well. So you kind of want to put assistants out, because as you move around, you're going to be picking up more of the basic resources. So this rondelle gets you resources. Alternatively, you can move on the effectively points rondelle. This one has got various actions that lets you get points. So again, you sort of move the number of spaces, but typically handing in resources. So if I went to this one, I could hand in a certain number of bread. You can convert wheat into bread on some of these spaces here. And you're gonna get, in this case, for each bread I handed in, I would get four people points. Now there's two kinds of points in this game. Here's the score track, and you see everyone's got a person and a house. And they're two different sets of points, and at the end of the game, your lowest one is your score. So blue, in this case, is scoring this value, 48 points, not this one. So it's always your lowest one that matters. So that will get you sort of a certain number of people points, and then I could hand a stone in, and that would get me five house points, plus two people points. This is quite nice, though. You're kind of racing for these things. Each time you take one of these actions, it moves down, and the points kind of get lower and lower as you go through the game. You can also hand in some wood here for house points. Another thing you can do on an action space is buy one of these guys here. You pay the resources at the top, and you're getting the stuff at the bottom. So it might be instant abilities, that's five people points, or a kind of one times, you can do this once per round, effectively, once per turn. You can hand in signets, so another kind of resource you can get here for more house points. There are some kind of permanent special ability things. I think you had one, Dean, didn't you? You can get a thing here which will give you a permanent ability through the rest of the game. So you kind of want to be buying those cards to help you either with instant abilities or permanent abilities. The other main spaces, though, you can go here to get the signets. You kind of cash in certain resources to get a signet. You can also hand in books for points. That's another kind of resource you can get. Why do you want signets? Well, what you really want is promotions. So at the start of the game, you are, what are you? Just sort of a basic dude. And you can upgrade to a baron. And then you can see there's a track here. You can become a count, and then a prince, a marquess, is that? And then a duke, finally. And you can see you're getting a whole pile of people points here if you manage to upgrade all the way up to there. So that's this space here. Now, this space is one of the ways of getting gold. You can hand resources and get gold. Gold is like a wild resource. You can use it for anything, so it's very useful and quite hard to come by. You can also hand books in again here, depending on the number you hand in, you get a certain number of people points. And incidentally, this is how you get the book. So when you go on this space, you get a book, you have to pay resources. And again, there's a nice thing where after you've paid the resources, this rotates round, so gradually people have to pay more and more resources as you're going through the game. But yeah, you get books and you get to take, you look at three of these and you kind of pick one, and it potentially gives you an extra bonus for visiting one of the other places later. So that's pretty much it. It's quite a lot of choice. When you play the card, as well as moving the number of spaces and doing the thing on the two rondelles there, you're also going to get the stuff. So it might just be a basic resource like this. Here, more basic resources. But some of the cards do a couple of extra nice things. This one makes it cheaper to put your assistants down, or cheaper to buy the guys to get you the stuff on the outside. That gives you an extra move. This one is another way of getting coins. This one lets you take any of the victory point type actions here, and more basic resources. So you play through, each of your cards gets played once, and then you collect them all together and you play them all once again, and then that's the end of the game. And as I said, the lowest of your two types of points is your score, and most points wins. What do we think?
I really quite like this game. I like the variety of things you can do. There isn't one set way of winning. There's a lot of different tactics, and the scoring system is really fascinating to me. I like kind of having to race myself, almost. I've got to keep up with that, and then there's a million races going on the board. Even with like the titles, they decrease in value as you kind of go through the piles, so the first person gets the most points. Yeah, it's a really, really interesting game. I like the fact that during my turn, there are so many different avenues I can go with something. If somebody does something that affects my turn directly, there's always something else I can do. It's not like, I never feel like I'm wasting a turn, which is nice. There's not sort of a, oh, I'm only getting bread this turn. It's, oh yes, I'm getting bread. So I really like that.
Steve?
It's actually really easy to pick this up. Taught it really quickly because we were in a rush for a short game. And if people aren't taking too long on their turns, it can last about an hour. So it's like that perfect dinky game that doesn't take too long. It's easy to teach. So it's really, really potentially underrated because no one's really talking about this game much that I've seen. And it's quite new. I really like Amy said, the scoring, kind of trying to maximise your weakest thing. I can really plow through, go through all these, get all these people points, some, you know, promotion, and come last because I haven't focused on my house points. In fact, in this particular game, I actually neglected to get my last 21 points from the people because it actually didn't change my actual endgame score, and it was better to keep over leftover resources just so that I could overtake Jonathan right at the end, which was really, really quite nice. There's not much interaction, but there is some. So basically, like Amy said, first come, first serve to some of the things. Basically, these dials here, you know, rotate. So basically, this action needs 2 wood, but when someone goes there, it now needs 3 wood. And these actions rotate. And when they're only one resource, they're really good. They're really good action. You get quite a lot of stuff for doing so when you're the first person to cash in bread and you get 7 points. But what will happen is instead of cashing those early points in, you could use the resources to kind of bump up the assistance there and get a bit of an engine going, which is how Dean won this particular game. But I've seen it go both ways. I've seen someone win by building very few assistants and kind of maxing, you know, trying to get the quick, cheap points and, you know, trying to snipe out all the little valuable spots to go to. But yeah, it's good.
Dean?
No, I like it. It's a good light game. There are lots of different strategies. It's actually quite difficult to go wrong as a new player in your first 2 or 3 turns because broadly whatever you do is probably decent in your first few turns. So that's quite nice because it means that in the first couple of card plays you won't have mucked it up, and by the time you've played 1 or 2 cards you then have a feel for what the game is. So it's quite a nice game for new people. I really like the mechanism of the 2 rondelles. It really does give you quite a good choice, and there are lots of different strategies, and your strategy may well depend on has somebody gone down the cheap and dirty route so that you want to build up your engine, or if people are building up your engine you might want to go down the cheap and dirty route. You can go down the promotion route. There really is a large string of strategies, and you probably want to be playing 1 or 2 strategies out of probably a choice of about 6. So I really like it. It's a nice fun game.
Rating?
I think I'd give it an 8.
7.5.
I'd also go with an 8.
I thought it was great, personally. It's a medium weight Euro. As Steve was saying, it's pretty easy to get into. At first, it's like, it's tricky because there's a lot of options, but it's not complicated. You explain all the things like, oh, I get resources here, I can cash them in for victory points over here. But every turn, it's like, well, I could put it in the 1 spot and move 1, or I could move 2 on this board, or that board, or the 3, or, and then you can play the card with the extra movement as well, and suddenly there are a lot of options. So unlike the fact that it's thinky, a little bit AP prone, but I think with practice it's fine, but it gives you a big bang for the buck, I suppose, in the sense that it's not too long. So you feel like you've played a heavy Euro, but actually it didn't take very long and it's not too complicated. It's just quite thinky because the options are interesting. There's lots of interesting decisions to make. So yeah, I really enjoyed this one. I'd be on an 8.5. All right, thanks very much for watching. That was Crown of Amara.